those of you that don't know who I am, I'm Auntie Becky, and we've been doing this for 36 years. Consecutively, we have never failed to put on a TV event. So I just want to say that for next year, the rules are the same, only the date will change. It'll probably be the third weekend in March, so the dates will change, but we will have the fit. There is never any doubt whether we have the fit. There is always a Kikirai na Tahiti fit forever. So we hope that you guys will come and support us. We are in our third generation of dancers, and so we hope you enjoy our program this evening. First of all, I would like to introduce our Mr. and Miss Mayama from last year, from 2014. First, we have Miss Chelsea Hill. They speak fluent Tahitian and French and English, and we're so proud to have them here. Right here on the far right, we have Auntie Lucy Fonoi Moana. Auntie Lucy traveled the world performing with the Northeast Television Cultural Center, teaching advisor and instructor for Moi Moia Productions, and who based in Lakea, Oahu. She also speaks fluent Tahitian and French, as is the case with all of our judges. She joins us now to share her knowledge and love of the culture. So that's Auntie Lucy. Next, Auntie Lucy, we have a new judge, so we're going to read a little bit about her. This is Te Po Te Marama Foster, Rikinman, from the islands of Tahiti. The Kikirai na Tahiti Fet would like to welcome a new judge from Tahiti. Of the Tuamotu Archipelago. She grew up in the Tuamotu Tahitian dance culture, where her mother, Mele, taught her and her sisters the fundamentals of the culture, as well as the Paumotu traditional dance. She was fortunate to also learn Tahitian dance with Koko Hotohota's Te Mayaka. She traveled extensively with the group touring Asia, Japan, China, Jakarta, and Singapore, as well as North and South America and Canada. Dancing professionally since she was 19, she helped to found the award-winning group Tamariki Poirani with her mother Mere Herako Foster and sisters Makau, Keha, Nadine, and Nadia. She's been a judge at Heiwei Tahiti and the Heiwei Tumului. She also participated in the Heiwei Tahiti with Te Maiwa for the group's 50th anniversary. This is Auntie Te. Also from Tahiti, we have Koko Hotohota, a legendary figure in Tahiti. Koko is a master of the art of Tahitian dance and has spoken the Tahitian, taken the Tahitian dance role by storm by being the next time we have a video in Tahiti. At a young age, she began with Te Maiwa, which is one of the most renowned professional Tahitian dance groups in the world. In addition, Koko functioned as one of the primary informants for the groundbreaking book, Dance of Tahiti, by Jane Freeman Mulan. So if you can get hold of that book, it's out of print, and it's worth a lot of money, so you better go find that book. And it tells you all the basics of Tahitian dance, so you really need to have that. So this is Koko Hokumoto. Next to Coco, we have Etua Tahoe, a native of the Tuamotus. Etua has dedicated his life to improving the understanding of Tahitian culture and dance. He's a regular sponsor of the Merry Monarch, Keiki Hula, and strong supporter of our Tahiti Fed. He studied at Brigham Young University in Hawaii and was a featured performer of the Polynesian Cultural Center on Oahu. Well known as a master carver, Etua specializes in making Hawaiian and Tahitian drums, which are available for sale through his company, the Polynesian Cultural Supply. So I'll go to Etua. And last but not least, this is Uncle Yonateri Ipaya. Fondly known as Papi, he's a native of Bora Bora, raised on the island of Taha'a, a master of Tahitian performance and production for many years. Papi worked as the director of Tihati's. His loving spirit and knowledge have earned him the respect and admiration of his friends, relatives, and business associates. So that's Papi Tari'ipani. Okay, are you ready to get started? Okay, drummers, why don't you give us a little introduction?
Thank you. Tiare Dandy, contestant number 599. Tiare is 18 years old and currently resides in Merced. She graduated from Murrieta Valley High School in Murrieta, California in 2014 and is currently attending Merced College. Tiare is pursuing her associate's degree in business and plans on transferring to either San Diego State or Hawaii University for her bachelor's degree in international business and marketing. Tiare is also studying the Japanese language so that she can have a career in Asian and the South Pacific. Recently, she was elected president of the Collegiate Entrepreneurs Organization Club. Tiare's heritage is Afantasi, half Samoan and half English, and she's been dancing since she could walk. Tiare loves embracing and learning about her culture and has traveled to Western and American Samoa to meet her family. In high school, she was in a Polynesian club and choreographed Polynesian dances for numerous shows and is always eager to share the Polynesian culture any chance she gets. This summer, she is excited to perform at Heiwei Tahiti with her group Te Maukata Loelua. Besides Polynesian dance, her passions include photography and writing. And I believe that's the Fareira. She's coming to Tahiti for the first time. Mr. Maya von Merced contestant, Arturo Guzman, number 600. Arturo is 18 years old and currently resides in Merced. He's graduated from Merced High School in 2014 and is attending Merced College. Arturo is pursuing his associate's degree in business and entrepreneurship. He plans on transferring to the Academy of Arts in either Los Angeles, San Diego, or Hawaii. Arturo is also studying French so that he's able to communicate when he travels to Tahiti. He was the president of the music club in high school and was recently elected president of the dance club at Merced College. Arturo's many talents include playing instruments such as a violin, ukulele, guitar, percussion, and piano. Being Latino, Arturo has had a passion for dance since he was 5 years old. He started out doing Latin and ballroom dancing and has won numerous trophies and awards. He joined Te Maukata Nuanua when he was 13 years old and has gained a new passion for drumming, dancing, and learning about the Polynesian culture. You can catch Arturo's house drumming throughout this year for Kupina and Tahiti Day. Thank you. Okay, so that was their eliminations. Now, all of those ladies that you just saw, since there are less than six in the category, they will all do a solo and they will be scored. And in this way, they will need, they will learn when they get their score sheets what they need to work on for next time. Okay, our Tahiti Fit is unique in the fact that we invite the drummers to come and play for their soloists. And the reason that this started is years ago, our drumming here in California wasn't so hot. It was really kind of bad. So the point of our event is to educate people. So what we started doing was asking the drummers to come because they would have to improve their drumming to play for their dancer. So it gives us kind of a really like well-rounded way of producing a festival for everyone, because the drummers certainly are a major part of your dance troupe. In the old days, some of us didn't even have drummers. We had to develop them. So because we needed to develop that, that's why we invite the drummers to come. And so we do have several groups of drummers that are sitting up at this time. Okay, while we're sitting up drummers, I do want to say a couple things about Merced. I belong to the Merced Dance Teachers Cooperative that's sponsored through the Merced College. And there are seven of us. And one of the other teachers is Bianca. Bianca is a belly dancer who's danced professionally and now lives here in Merced. And she teaches at the college. So we invited her and her dancers to do a little something. So we're going to have them come out and do a little something while we wait for the drummers to set up and warm up your hand a little bit. And it's another way of encouraging dance as a whole art, and for us to realize that dance is not only our kind of dance. There's lots of different kinds of dance. So we try to make sure that we still have that all over the place. So here at the festival we share, and Bianca has been very gracious enough to offer her dancers for dance this evening. Thank you.
deal with head movement and body movement. So they're very similar, but not quite the same, are they?
No.
And we're going to show you what's not quite the same. We're going to go into the ladies' masters category. And number 213, judges, you need a score sheet, please. A score sheet. Number 213. So just to remind the judges, you're just going to write their number on their score sheet and circle.
Thank you.
number 214. Thank you. And next, we have dancer number 359. judges.
Good job, my friend.
Okay, so while the judges are scoring that, we're going to bring out our Miami contestants again. First we have Ms. Tiare Bagby. Tiare's traditional costume represents where the land meets the sea in Tahiti at sunset. Cascades of Mahe and Mahe are the aoa, symbolizing the many waterfalls that can be found around the island. A variety of feathers are used to represent the many birds that fly over the sea. Tiare's skirt is a beautiful orange hue that can be seen in the Tahitian sunsets. Her top is covered with white and pearl shells, and a mother of pearl shell adorns her head, her cape, capturing the pure and natural beauty that is Tahiti. Thank you. This is Ms. Tiare Bagby. We also have Arturo Guzman. Arturo's costume is inspired by the flora and fauna of Tahiti. His tiare has a monstera and palm leaf print, representing the vast variety of colors of Tahiti around the island. Arturo's hay is made of fresh tea leaves, and his lei is made from the fragrant yellow plumeria, which represents the sweet smell of the island air. He also dons a traditional Hawaiian tea leaf adornment on his arm and leg. Arturo wanted to capture the true beauty of the islands of Tahiti in his costume. Thank you. This is Arturo Guzman. Moving on to the Grand Masters category of the Wahine. Okay, the next contestant in the Mahine Masters is number 221. Judges, thank you. 221. We ready, judges? Okay. Thank you. Thank you, judges. Thank you. Our next dancer is number 376. 376.
To our age,
that you guys just keep going and don't stop just because you think you're, you know, a little older. It has nothing to do with how you feel your music or how you dance. So you just gotta keep going, right? Yes. Okay, so now we come to the interview portion of the pageant. I would like to invite Miss Tiana Danby to come here and we will have her do her question. So Tiana, you have to pick a number. Between 1 and 5. Okay, number 4. How has Tahiti left a mark on our society, and what are the benefits of sharing the culture with others?
Throughout the world, people gather around for festivals just like this one to share a love of Polynesian culture and dance and music. And I think that your Tahitian culture brings like a unity. We all feel like a family putting this together and sharing our love for culture.
Such a beautiful costume, we have to see it again. And while she's doing that, we're going to invite Arturo Guzman. Arturo? Okay, Arturo. Pick a number between 1 and 5, but not number 4. Number 2. Question number 2. But I can still dance. Okay. What is your first impression of Tahiti and its culture, and why is it significant to you?
Actually, my first impression for the Tahiti culture, I didn't know what to expect. My roots are not Polynesian whatsoever, but I have come to love it, and it's grown to be a part of me now in my day in life. And I would love it. It's the best thing that's ever happened.
One more time. This is Arturo Guzman. Arturo came here from Mexico when he was 13. Has danced immediately, so he's been dancing for a long time now. And I don't know, I think you guys all know that in Mexico there's a lot of fets now, right? There's at least 2 or 3 Tahitian fets, and there's hula and everything. And so this is a culture, the Tahitian culture is embraced by many, many people all over the world. So I'm hearing of festivals all over the world now. You'll see an increase in the festivals. We hope that you still come back to us, though. Okay, this is Miss and Mr. Mayava contestants. Give them a big hand. Thank you. Okay, so I have a few notes before we continue on. And I don't know what I did with the prizes. I think they're up there. Maybe. Thank you. Okay, so the dancers that perform this evening will have scores. The advanced dancers that perform, the first place winner will go on to the overall competition, which is on Sunday. They will be announced on Saturday night. Who is the advanced winners on Saturday night will be announced. And then on Sunday morning they'll compete for overall. Award ceremony will be on Sunday afternoon. So if you have any questions, you can get hold of me after you're done here. Now, one of the things about the Mayava pageant is they get a lot of prizes. And so some of the prizes they'll get today, and some they'll get tomorrow, and some they'll get the next day, because that's how we do it. It's a nice thing to be able to award prizes to someone who is taking their time to represent our culture. And I have to say that Ryan and
Chelsea have been wonderful representatives, and I hope it was fun for them to come in at the fair and represent. And they've done a really fine job of being ambassadors for the Tahitian culture. I hope to see them both in Tahiti this year, so very exciting to go to the boat. On a side note, thank you to the drummers that have come here today. House drummers, Ocha Abdi, give them a big hand. We have the resort drummers. We have the Island Way represented here. And then drummers from Kimong Tata Nuranu. Okay, one of the first prizes that my Emma gets is they get the new t-shirt, and they get a program, and they get the banner. And tomorrow they're going to get more stuff in the morning when they come. And I do have to say the banners are quite beautiful. And Chelsea actually was the craftsman for the banners, and they're really, really beautiful, Chelsea. Thank you so much. And the things to make the banners were donated by California Hula Supply. So thank you, California Hula Supply. They're in Stockton. So if you need hula supplies and you're here and you want it right away, then you go to Stockton and you go to California Hula Supply, who has a booth over there in the cafeteria. So everybody, do go by the booth this evening as you're leaving, and make sure you hit the food booth, okay? So shall we announce? Thank you. And the winner of the Miami Merced Miss Miami pageant today, this year, is Miss Tiare Dampy. Yeah. I thought they were really great because they knew that they were going to be the ones today, so. Yes. But they will both make really, really good representatives, and they will come and do things with us throughout the year. You know, different festivals and things like that. So, and Tiare is going to Farereira'a this year in Tahiti, so she'll be dancing there this year. So. And then, Mr. Miami Merced is Arturo Guzman. And next year, we hope that we'll have more entrants. Since you guys know a year ahead of time that we are having the event, so some of you should prepare for that. Besides these things, they bring money, they bring attendance, there will be trophy, cash, all of that. Thank you. This is Arturo and Tiare. And I hope you guys are prepared to open the program. Yes, he's a hand. Yes. But that's what it takes. So hopefully we'll have a few more guys up here next year and a few more girls. So everybody give them a big hand. Enjoyed our little pageant this year.